Good morning. It's Wednesday today. Tomorrow I will not be doing anything. I have to go out. But people seem to have been fascinated with my discussions about some supernatural, the occult, paranormal. So I thought we might look at some terminology and again done research. Because I feel that this has recently happened to me, that some person had with intent wanted to cause mischief, and you can actually do this, but more about this later. So I thought we'd look at some terminology of undesirable intent. The word curse is to invoke or use a curse against someone. In Wiccan and similar beliefs, this involves incantations and spells. Used in a sentence, "She seemed cursed" implies bad luck or misfortune. "He cursed burning his hand" usually means swearing or foul language. A curse is usually from malicious, jealous, hatred, angry, vengeful, poisonous people, or people who are just practicing black arts or the occult, or people just wanting to have fun to see what will happen. Curses is a fusion of Christian and pagan traditions with a heavy emphasis on magic or the occult. Ireland is a famous for the lore of banshees, witches, superstition, hexes, and even cures. The witch hunt in the Middle Ages was often pointed at innocent victims because of the belief of curses. Blights in cattle, pestilence, sickness in people, which may have just been natural infestations, meaning just naturally happened, and led to the death and many horribly suffering for the crimes of which they may or may not have committed. I mean, we're still pretty superstitious, aren't we? In Wicca, the rule of three, or threefold law, or law of return, based on whatever energy a person puts out, positive or negative, returns to that person threefold. Now, I, in my 20s, after breaking up of Christianity, got into Wiccan. And I realized that the power of being really negative, the power of anger especially, was such a strong force to use that I used it wrongly against other people, and I did suffer the threefold law of returning that intent. But I have noticed that if you put love out there, love returns to you threefold. Now, I told you in videos before of some of my things that I could do when I was practicing Wicca. And some people can get right into Wicca. There's actually, you know, stones, crystals involved, writing names, incense, burning the full moon, all that stuff. It's the power of the mind. And I really believe in the power of the mind. If there's a very, I don't know if this is true, but there was a story going around decades ago that this person was cursed by a, the magic man of a certain tribe, and he was cursed with a stone. And what it means in a stone was found in his body, and he actually died because he believed in the hex so strongly that it was found that he had a stone, and he died from that. I also had friends who been diagnosed with, on the opposite end, she was diagnosed, she had gallbladder stones, and they said that they had never seen such big gallstones in all their life, and she had to go into hospital. She had that night to get her stuff and come in the next morning for an operation. The next morning she came in for an operation. They did a scan. The stones had gone. And the fact was that she was a strong Christian and she prayed. And she prayed and the stones were gone. I'm not a Christian. I'm not religious. But I know what the power of the mind can do. I have had seances where it's been questioned that I have been pushing it. And so I've said, take, all right, I'll sleep, leave me on, and you should never do this. Never do this. Leave me with the hand on it and ask a question I couldn't possibly know the answer to. And I got it right. So there are, not only is the power of the mind, there are on earth equal and opposite forces. So I believe for every Christian, and there is a demon, because the world has to balance. I don't really believe that in real reality, once we die, that this happens. I believe earth is a place where entities can come from outer space, interdimensional, and they don't have to be good or bad. They can be all range. And there are entities that don't see, we see them as evil, but they don't see them as evil because that's their game that they are playing. But there are opposite and opposing forces, and I have seen curses work. So I'm just bringing it up again, and it was a very brief introduction. Please, if you are going to get into the occult, know what you are getting into, and know that to harm, to deliberately put a curse to harm someone or something returns to you. So you're the one who gets harmed. And with that, thank you to new subscribers, and we'll leave. I just have to share with you what's happening in my life. Since I went and did smudging and ritual cleansing, that particular person still tried. They're still, you know, they're saying, leave me alone, leave me alone, and I'm doing the right thing, stayed away from them. And one night I got a call, a private call. I'm not going to answer private calls. Good try, no cigar, but you're out of my life, you're evil, you're gone. And I will not deal with evil. I have said this every day. I make videos. I'm open to show you how I made mistakes. You can see from the start of my videos, my first YouTubes, the mistakes I made. And that I was in a very toxic, drug addicted place. And that through with therapy, with the help of good people, I am trying to be the best version of myself. I haven't always been. I've made quite a lot of mistakes. And that's why I make the videos. So you can learn from me. You can learn what not to do, what's right. And hopefully we will learn to respect and love one another. And forgiveness is the biggest thing, because we all hurt everybody. And also learn to say, I'm sorry. You might not even be in the wrong. It doesn't matter. The fact I'm going to say, I'm sorry, and truly mean, I'm sorry. The intent of truly meaning, I'm sorry, the intent that I truly forgive, the intent that I truly want to put love out there, makes the world a better place. Let's all try it together. Thanks for watching. And it really, I just, one last thing, totally off the topic. There's a character quiz that you can do online to test your 24 top character strengths. And 6 different times I have done it now, and my number one strength is honesty. So to be called a liar is very hurtful. I would not go on YouTube unless I really believed in what I am saying. So if I'm a liar, then I'm really living in a fantasy world. And again, I apologize to those I have harmed. I forgive those who have harmed me. Let's end this year on a positive note. Let's start the new year, fresh beginnings and love. Bye, and thank you.